Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, I'm going to show you how to transfer video from an SD card onto your iPad. Now, suppose you're traveling and your iPad's the only device that you've got with you, and you want to store a bunch of videos on it, maybe to watch on the airplane. But there's not enough space. Well, you can store some video on an SD card and bring that SD card with you and transfer that video onto your iPad to watch. Now, it doesn't work, of course, with things like purchased or rented videos. These are videos that you've got on your own separate from that. And it assumes, of course, that you've saved those videos in a format that's compatible for playback on your iPad. You can convert them using iTunes, or if you're using video conversion software, just make sure you set it to be compatible with the iPad. Then you can store them on one of these and use some adapters to plug an SD card into your iPad and transfer the videos there. But it's a little tricky. It doesn't work very intuitively. So the first thing I want to show you is how I put the video on the SD card. The first thing I did is I want to trick the iPad into thinking this is a card coming from my camera. I don't want to just trick it. I want to actually make it a card coming from my camera. So I plugged the SD card into a standard camera. I formatted it using it there. And then the next thing I did was take a short video using my camera. And this was just to get an idea of how it stores video. So I was able to see here when I plugged this SD card into my Mac using either a slot on the side of a MacBook, or you can get a cheap adapter to plug it into your Mac through USB. I can see that I've got the SD card here. It creates a DCIM folder, which most cameras do. Under that, it creates a folder for the current day. And under that, it stuck my video. And I can see it named it MVI underscore and then some numbers .mov. Great. So I want to basically replace this short video I took with my camera with an actual video, say of something I want to watch on the airplane. I want to either replace it or just put it sequentially next with the next number, 1112, 1113, etc., and put these movies there on the SD card. So the next thing I want to do is I want to take the adapter and put the SD card into it. I'm going to use the Apple official SD card adapter for the old 30-pin dock, and I've put an adapter to go to a Lightning connector on that. Today, of course, you can get a Lightning to SD card adapter for $29 from Apple, and it's great for transferring photos to your iPad or any other iOS device, but also great for this. I'm going to plug in the whole thing into my iPad here, and then I'm going to go and launch the Photos app there. And it's going to show up now inside the Photos app as something I can import. So there you go. You see it shows up there under camera, and now I can hit import all and it will import all those videos, or I can select the individual video, the check mark, and import just that one. Now here's where it gets strange. You don't actually then see the video show up under videos. You see it show up in your Photos app because it acts like a video that you took with your camera. So it's kind of strange. Say you take some movies and you put them on an SD card and you use this technique, it will import them in, and then to watch these movies you go to your Photos app, you find the video there like it was something that you took with your camera, and you can watch it from your Photos app. But it does work fine. Matter of fact, it works just as well as it does the Videos app. You can even stream it with an HDMI adapter to a TV if you're traveling and you have that ability, or use AirPlay to stream it. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.